Hi everybody. Today we're going to be going over proper wine service in a typical restaurant setting. This video is going to go over tips for helping customers select the wine, suggestions for presenting wines with poise and professionalism, how to open a bottle tableside, and tips for successfully pouring the wine. So you want to start off with taking the wine order. Many diners rely on their servers to suggest a wine they would enjoy. When the guest has a good experience, the guest tips well, the server is happy, and the restaurant is successful. When taking the wine order, be prepared to have an understanding about what the wine your restaurant offers and how it pairs with entrees and what you can do to assist guests in their decision. It's important to be knowledgeable about the wine list. Restaurant servers are obliged to have a basic knowledge of the restaurant's menu. If the restaurant has a wine list, it is even more important that the server understand the wine that's on the list and be prepared to discuss with the guests. People often want their server to provide direction, and a server is doing a disservice to the guest if he or she cannot provide insight on the wine list. You want to make sure you help your guest decide on a bottle of wine. When assisting a guest in a decision, ask about what kind of wine they enjoyed in the past. If a guest has a memory of a wine they enjoyed in the past, it makes it easier for the server to suggest something similar. If there is a wine that they remember disliking, this can also assist the server in helping selecting something the guest is more likely to enjoy. Another technique is to ask about what the guest wants to order for dinner. Basic wine pairing etiquette suggests pairing a chicken, fish, and pasta dish with white wines, while red meats, ducks, and tomato-based dishes often taste great with red wine. The important thing is to open the dialogue. The server should never make a negative remark on the guest selection, his or her pronunciation, or anything that could suggest a lack of wine knowledge. When a customer is unsure what to order, but only wants a glass, he or she may ask for a sample of the wine. If the bar has a bottle of wine that is already open, they might pour a small taste in a wine glass for the guests to try before ordering a full glass or even a bottle. Presentation is important in many aspects of the restaurant and beverage industry, but especially important when it comes to serving a bottle of wine. When a customer orders a bottle, there are certain steps to follow that offer the guests the best of service, attention to detail, and overall experience. In general, handle the wine bottle with care, as shaking it could agitate any sediment in the bottle. Once your guest has decided on a glass or a bottle of wine, show the bottle to the guest who ordered it. It doesn't matter if the guest who ordered it is an inexperienced 21-year-old person, just make sure that you show them the bottle. When bringing the wine bottle to the table, show it to the person who ordered it, who will be the initial taster. If a man and woman are dining together and the woman orders the wine, it is considered insulting to the woman if the server immediately presents the wine to the man. If a group at one table orders collectively and they negotiate on the type of wine that they would like, it is appropriate to ask the table which of them would like to taste the wine when you return to the table. Be sure to hold the bottle so that the guests can verify the label and communicate their approval. So basically what you want to do is just kind of go over to the table and show the bottle of wine to the guests so they can see that this is the right bottle that they ordered. Now that your guest has selected a wine, it's time to open the bottle at the table. Before opening the wine, make sure that everybody has a glass of wine in front of them. So what you want to do is get your wine key, and on the wine key, there's a little knife. You want to cut the foil. You want to go around the foil at the base of the lip of the bottle, and you should have a nice ring that it comes off cleanly. You want to put this in your pocket or in your apron, never put it on the actual tablecloth. Now there's a corkscrew on your wine key. You want to place that right at the top of the cork, and you're going to give it a nice turn so that it goes smoothly into the cork. Most wine keys have a double lip right here, so you want to make sure that the lip of the wine bottle is right there, and you lift up. After you have opened the wine, you want to place the cork to the right of the taster. Some people like to feel it to make sure it's moist. A dry cork may signal spoiled wine. Other guests choose to smell the cork. Even if the cork is made of rubber or is simply a screw cap, the server should still place it to the right of the guest and continue service. Now it's time to pour the wine at the table. The moment of truth really comes when the server pours the wine and the guest tastes it for the first time. The guest will no doubt pay attention while you pour the wine and will be eager to try a taste. The server should be skilled at pouring wine gracefully and without drips. Now it's time to pour the wine. The initial pour is always for the person tasting the wine. Sparkling wine should be poured slowly against the inside of the wine glass, while still wine can be poured to the center of the glass. Pour enough to about maybe a half inch up from the bottom of the glass, just so they can get a little taste. Roll with the bottle slightly when finishing after your pour so you don't get any drips. Like so. Once the sample of wine is poured, it is proper to allow the guests to swirl the wine, view it in the glass, smell it, and finally taste before deciding to accept it. Once accepted, move immediately to the other guests at the table. Some operations suggest servers simply move around the table clockwise, while others insist that women should be served first, starting with the eldest lady, ending with the youngest. Follow with the men at the table, and finish with the person who ordered the wine. Pour size will depend on how many guests are seated at the table, but the server should aim to fill each glass to no more than half full. Wine service is often looked at as one of the more important service techniques in the industry, especially in a fine dining establishment. Servers should be well-versed in the etiquette of discussing, presenting, and pouring wine. Many guests perceive the wine service to have equal, if not greater, importance than that of the food. Delivering polished, elegant service when it comes to wine helps leave guests with a positive impression regarding the restaurant as a whole.